Integrating InvGate Service Desk with Zapier is an easy way to connect with popular tools and create amazing workflows. Hi, Matt Barron, Product Specialist at InvGate. Today, we're going to create some simple notifications you might want on your service desk to raise attention to major incidents or other requests in the InvGate Service Desk. We're going to make it so that when a new request is created in Service Desk, it is linked in our Slack channel. In order to complete this, you'll want a trial version of both InvGate Service Desk and Zapier. There are links in the description to get your free trials. Once you have your free trials, we'll get started. Simply log into Zapier, and from the dashboard, we're going to create a new Zap. We'll put in InvGate Service Desk here, and Slack. And then we're going to choose the trigger New Request for this demonstration. And for Slack, we're going to post a channel message. Now you can see what our Zap is going to be here. And we're going to move towards trying it. Now Zapier is going to walk us through setting this up. I'm going to get a prompt right away to log in to InvGate Service Desk. So I'm going to need to create a service account. I'm going to go into InvGate Service Desk, go to Settings, Integrations, and here you can see applications that we commonly integrate with, as well as your ability to control which users you're using for your APIs. For now though, we're going to go to API and create a new account. I'm just going to call this one Zapier, and I'm going to generate a key here. You also can add restrictions for what the account is able to access, but for now we're just going to hit save. We'll head back to Zapier, and now we're going to populate those same details, the username, the key, as well as the URL for our instance. Now I'll click continue. And we're connected. Now Zapier is going to try to get a request out of our system. I haven't created any requests recently, so we need to do that quick. I'm just going to go in here and create a generic request very quickly. And now back in Zapier, we're going to try that test again. Now we can validate that it worked. Now it's time to connect our Slack account. I just need to allow this, and you can see my ticket volume Slack channel is already added. I can hit next, and it's going to ask me which channel I want to post these messages in, and obviously I want to choose the service desk. And we're just going to send a message text straight, we don't need anything fancy. So at this point, it gives us a field to fill out what we want that Slack message to read like. In Zapier, we're going to add text from the integration to make the message that gets posted in Slack. Great. Now we'll hit next, and Zapier will run a quick test. We can validate that it worked, and now we're going to finish by turning on the Zap. So I'm going to go through these next couple steps to turn it on, and we're done. My last step is going to be to create a new request in Service Desk just to test out this integration. So I'm going to create one more request here. We'll just pick something simple, like I've got a question. And we're just going to put in a sample set here and say, this is a Slack test. Please make sure this integration works. Now I'll create that request and we'll head on over to Slack to make sure that that message posts properly. And here's how it appears in Slack. If I click on the link, it takes me right to the ticket. And this is just a small example of what can be done with a Zapier integration. There are a ton of different apps that you can integrate through this marketplace. Stay tuned to learn more about how to use InvGate tools, as well as many, many other topics. I hope you found this video useful, and I hope to see you again soon.